Hey guys, I'm Adrian.
Hey, I'm Nick.
And welcome to another episode of Connect. Today we're bringing along our friend Casey O'Grady to talk a little bit about Bluetooth 5 and what it's bringing to the table within the SimpleLink platform. So Casey, so what's new with Bluetooth 5?
Bluetooth 5 brings three new features. First, long range through coded PHYs. Second, high speed. Can't get both of them at the same time, so it is one or the other. And then the third feature is called advertising extensions.
Awesome. And when you say longer range, it's enabled by coded PHYs. What exactly does that mean?
So traditionally, Bluetooth is at 1 megabit per second. They're using coded PHYs of 125 kilobits per second or 500 kilobits per second. So with using the coded PHYs and forward error correction, now you're improving the receiver sensitivity without increasing the output power.
Awesome.
So you do have ability to transmit longer distance, but the same peak current consumption.
Okay, cool. So you're kind of getting the best of both worlds.
Yes.
And when you talk about that improved range, how does that compare to traditional or older Bluetooth implementations?
Bluetooth historically has been really catered at personal area networks or single home coverage. Now with Bluetooth 5, it's opening up the doors for full home coverage, even across multiple stories within a building.
Very cool.
Okay. And at least for me, when you say advertising extension, can you explain a little bit more what that is and why it's important to customers or users?
Yes. So now with advertising extensions, you can actually send more data over a beacon. So it's up to 255 bytes of data, which is a big increase compared to Bluetooth 4.0 or 4.2. So now with any sort of beacon application, whether you're in a retail environment, a sports arena, a museum, you can actually send a user more data to their smartphone app, and it really enhances the user experience with any wayfinding or connectionless type of applications.
Okay. Yeah, and when I hear features like that, like advertising extension or the longer range, my head automatically jumps to new applications, new use cases for Bluetooth 5, because Bluetooth celebrated a birthday recently, 20 years, and we've seen it go from audio to home to being adopted into the smartphone. So what does Bluetooth 5 bring that's new for applications?
Yes, Bluetooth 5 is really emerging new applications in terms of industrial and automotive. So we're getting away from just personal electronics and personal area networks, now having connected homes, connected buildings, connected retail environments. And then now you can actually use your smartphone to start your car or unlock your vehicle from longer ranges than before.
Love it. And we talked a little bit about, I guess, the technology and what it brings to the table. Is there anything TI is doing specifically for added differentiation with Bluetooth 5?
Absolutely. So we actually have the smallest Bluetooth 5 SOC in the market, so the CC2640R2F. It comes in a 2.7 by 2.7 millimeter chip seal package, so really tiny. Great for any sort of designs that are space constrained and you're looking to make that PCB board as small as possible.
Awesome. So are we talking about like wearables, patches, disposables, those types of end equipments?
All of the above. So wearables, smartwatches, and medical applications specifically. So any sort of wireless patient monitor, blood glucose monitor, a disposable patch, even folks that are building modules want to leverage the smallest size package as possible.
Very cool.
And like total solution size, device, components around it, we're talking like a quarter in that range?
In that range, okay. Absolutely. Wow. So 2.7 millimeters is really, really small.
Yeah, very cool. Very cool.
Awesome. Cool. Well, thank you so much for hanging out with us, Casey. Learned a lot about Bluetooth 5. You can learn more about our portfolio at ti.com/SimpleLink and specifically ti.com/Bluetooth5 to learn more about our particular technology. You can tune in next week where we'll be talking about additional hands-on demos using the SimpleLink platform. And be sure to follow this guy at Sensor2Cloud. Ask us any questions or even suggest additional topics for future episodes. So thank you very much for watching.
Thanks, everybody.